Hello, this is Christy. In this video, I would like to show you an audio effect that is built into Camtasia. It was added in a recent version, and it allows you to create a ducking effect, or it allows you to have music or any other audio playing in the background while your speech is going. So if you have a tutorial maybe, or a video on YouTube or something like that, and you want to add some background music, the ducking effect, or emphasize as it's called in Camtasia, will help you protect that audio file, your speech, from the music that is playing, and it will automatically lower the volume or raise the volume of the music when you stop talking. So let me show you how this effect works. We can find this effect in the audio effects. If you go to the sidebar here, audio effects, you will see this effect here called emphasize. But let me show you what happens without this effect first. So I created here a tutorial on my timeline in Camtasia, and I have the video of me talking, which starts around 9 seconds here. This is my video starting to play, and I've got my voice on that file too. And then I added a title screen just as an example for you where there is no audio, there's no speech. So the bottom track, which I'm going to double click and call music, the bottom track is a music file. So watch what happens if the music is playing and the speech starts. Hello, this is Christy. A very quick video for you to show you two ways to remove your background. So you can see that's quite annoying because when I start speaking, the music remains loud and it's very distracting and it's overpowering the speech. Well, this is what the emphasize effect does. Add this effect to the audio file that you want to protect. So it's not added to the music file, it's added to the speech track. Okay, so let's see how that works. I'm going to grab this emphasize effect and add it to my video file here, the one that has the audio that I want to protect or keep playing loudly. Okay, so click on that, and I'm not going to make any changes to the actual effect yet. I'm going to explain what they do, but before that, let's see what happens. So I'm going to play again from the beginning where there is no speech, and watch what happens now when the speech starts. Hello, this is Christy. A very quick video for you. Much better, isn't it? Because now the emphasize effect makes sure that any other audio that is on the timeline will be lowered. The volume of that audio will be lowered just before the speech starts, or just before the track you're trying to protect starts. In other programs, this effect is called ducking because that's what it does. You apply it to a track, and then when that track starts playing, or the audio on that track starts playing, it is ducking or reducing the volume of everything else on the timeline as to protect your audio. So this is how it works. Now, what are these options on the side here? The first one is emphasis. Okay, so by default in Camtasia, this ducking effect is reducing everything by about 80%. So what this means is that that is the amount of reduction you want to make to the audio that you're trying to dip in volume. So if I set that to about 10%, let's have a look. I'm going to say 10%. And now let's play again.
Hello, this is Christy.
It's only lowering it 10%, which is almost, you know, you can't even tell it was reduced. So the more you do, the more this is reduced, the more the audio is reduced. So if I do about 95%, that's a very big reduction. And it's probably going to be like, you're not even going to be able to hear the audio anymore, the music.
Hello, this is Christy. A very quick...
See, that's a very, very big reduction. So basically, you're just hearing only 5% of the volume of those tracks. So that's how that works, the emphasis. Then the second one is the ramp. How do you want the ramp to happen? Well, the first one in default is outside, which means the music will be reduced before the speech starts. So as you heard probably, and I'm going to play this again, you're going to see that the volume is actually reduced before I start talking. Watch this. So you see, I haven't already started talking and the volume is already low. That is what the outside ramp means. The span means that the volume will be reduced while you've just started playing, And then the other one, the inside, is after you start speaking, then the volume starts to be reduced. So let's try this one. So you can probably see that you're going to hear that for like a second or so. You're going to hear the music still quite loud.
Hello, this is Christy. A very quick...
So you see, I already started talking and the volume was still quite loud, and then it got reduced immediately. So this is what that setting does. It controls the when the reduction happens. I usually prefer to do it outside because I want the music to be already low when I have started talking. And there's two more settings, the ramp in and out, the duration. So how long does this ramp last? How long before you start talking would you like the music to be reduced? And also after you stop talking, how long until the music goes back to full volume? So 1 second is the default on that. So that's what those settings do. And by the way, if you want to try this without removing the effect, you can turn it off with this setting right here. So you can see now it's not going to do it.
Hello, this is Chris.
Okay. And this actually works across the whole file. So if I have my tutorial, you know, it's quite long. And let's say that sometimes I may interrupt my audio and I'm going to, you know, show like a title screen or something like that. The music should automatically go to full volume in those cases. So let me demonstrate. So somewhere here in the middle of the file, let's assume in this point, I'm going to make a cut in my audio, in my video with the S key while it's selected. I'm going to delete that portion. Okay, so now there's no video here. So for this portion, the audio should go back to full volume. Let's see.
Make this larger just so you can see better. You find this in the...
So as you can see, it goes back to lower volume when the speech starts again. And you can do this by, you know, if you want to insert a title in here, or you can even just silence that audio or remove the audio from the video. One situation that I want to show you is that's not going to work. If I bring that portion back in and I silence it, so let's suppose that I want to keep the video playing, but the audio, I want to silence that, silence, it's not going to do it.
You can see better.
Yeah. So although there is no audio playing, that little segment still has the effect applied to it, which means it's not going to allow the music to go back to full volume. So if that's the case, if that's what you want, you can just select that segment and turn off the emphasize effect just for that segment. Watch this now.
So you can see better.
Okay, so now even the volume is low, the audio is muted on that little video part, the emphasize is off, so that allows the music to go right back. It's just like as if the effect was off and that video segment wasn't even there. So that's how you can control the availability of this effect. You have to slice it and remove it. There you go. This is how the ducking effect works. And it also applies if you have multiple audio files. So if I have, let's say, audio file, music, and sound effects and everything else, the emphasize only applies to the main track, the speech track, and it will automatically lower the volume of everything else. Okay, so that's how you do it. And this percentage, by the way, is relative to the volume of the audio file. So if I said here 95%, that's quite a low reduction, that's quite a low volume, but it is relative to the volume of the file itself. So if I go to my music track and I increase the gain by quite a lot, it's going to affect that percentage because it's a percentage. It's going to make it sound louder despite the fact that you did a percentage there. It's going to be relative to the volume of the file itself. So I hope that makes sense. So thank you. I hope this was useful. And if you have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, if it was useful to you, feel free to like it, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you on the next one.